what do you do with this compost that was done? And I spent years figuring out how best to use compost. When I was first hired, they said, okay, we want you to, is compost good? And I thought, God, this is going to be easy research. Of course compost is good, I mean, what is there to learn? And there was quite a bit to learn. But the main thing, yes, compost is very good to put on your garden. You can visit a plot over by the silo, which has been getting compost since 1981 every year. Supposedly it's the longest running compost experiment in the country. So a little bit of history there. And what we were trying to see there is whether you, if you added compost every year, whether you could eliminate using lime and fertilizer completely. And we have found, yes, you can. Okay, the bottom line, and we grow a variety of vegetables. You can see what's growing there now. We grow different ones every year. But you can equal, we have a plot that has a full rate of lime and fertilizer, a plot that has two-thirds the rate of lime and fertilizer plus compost, one-third the rate of lime and fertilizer plus compost, no lime and fertilizer and compost. And then we compare that to a plot that has no compost, just the full rate of lime and fertilizer. And we have found that we can equal the zero plot that gets compost every year but gets no lime and fertilizer. The yields are equal to that that gets the full rate of lime and fertilizer and no compost. Got that? Now, another take-home message is, but those weren't the highest yields. The greatest yields were if you added a little bit of fertilizer and lime plus compost. And you can reduce it. You don't have to do the full rate. If you do like one-third the normal rate of lime and fertilizer, you get tremendous yields. If you use the one-third the rate plus compost, you get tremendous yields. So that's all like an individual preference. If you don't want to use inorganic fertilizer at all, you can be certain if you put compost down every year, you can equal another if you were using full rate of fertilizer. But if you want even greater yields, you can add a little bit of lime and fertilizer and you'll get even better yields. I should say it takes a while for it to build up. You're not going to get equal yields the very first year. You want to build it up in the soil. And what happens to the soil? Why are you getting such better yields? How are you doing that? And we looked at all different soil characteristics. Number one, you're increasing the organic matter by adding compost every year. We've more than doubled it from about 5% to over 12%, which means it's be classified as an organic soil. Now, what does organic matter do? It does a lot of things. The most important thing it does is that it increases the moisture holding capacity of the soil, which means it holds more water, which means it can go through droughty periods a lot easier. Also adds a lot of nutrients. Another thing it does is it decreases the bulk density of the soil. Now, what's the bulk density? Bulk density is basically the weight per unit volume of soil. So the soil, I've forgotten what the background soil is. It's like 1.5 or something. And adding the compost has gone down below 1. It's 0.9 something. Now, to give you an idea, the density of water is 1. So this soil is like lighter than water. It's fluffy, lighter. Now, if you think of yourself as a plant root, what's easier? It's a lot easier to go through a light, fluffy soil to scavenge nutrients. So that's really good to have a lower bulk density. So again, the lowest density of the soil increases the water holding capacity and also reduces the need for lime and fertilizer. We have sort of acidic soils here, and background pH is around like 3 or 4, and you want about 6.5. here to grow vegetables that have the nutrients available. And the plot that has not gotten any lime since 1980, the pH is 6.5. So that's perfect. So it's having the liming effect. So it brings it up into the right spot in the pH meter.